finally did it. Y'all are gonna think I'm so gross, but I don't know why it is so hard for me to take a shower. Don't know how to just wake up and take a shower. It takes so much effort. I don't know how to fix that. It's just something that I struggle with. Yeah, that's nasty. I haven't showered in over a week. My name's Kayleen. I'm a mom of two special needs children, a business owner, a content creator, and an author. I love Jesus. I'm shaving my face because I have hair, peach fuzz, and a mustache. Ow, shoot! Oh man, that hurt. Oh. But I finally did it. I took a shower. I cut myself just now. That hurt. I can't do the next steps. I can do the next steps. It's hard for me to do the next steps. I'm gonna try to do the next steps. I don't know why I have to hype myself up. Today is such a hard day for me. Sometimes I can't breathe. Sometimes I'm like, Lord, why? But I'll do it. I'll do it anyways, God. I slept on my neck wrong last night, so I have a ink in it. I at least wash my face every day. I don't wash my hair maybe 4 times a month because I don't have the effort to blow dry my extensions. Here comes my son. Yes, Bubba. I'm gonna help you. I didn't hear what you said. Can you say it again?
Louie.
You want to play Louie?
No, Louie.
Mario.
Yes.
Okay. Well, we can't right now. You can go upstairs if you want to. Do you want to take the dogs?
Yes, take the dogs.
Okay.
Take
the dogs. Anyways, so my name's Kayleen. I recently cut myself shaving my mustache. That's funny because I'm a woman, but it's okay. I'm a mom to 2 special needs kids. I took a big girl shower today. I call it a big girl shower because it's an everything shower. Shaving, hair washing, all the things. And for me, it takes a lot of effort. I recently discovered that I am diagnosed ADHD at the age of 29. So weird to me. It makes sense with how my brain works, but to me, it's normal. Like, that's just how my brain has always functioned. But the reason why I went and finally got tested is because my sister and brother-in-law moved in a while back. My brother-in-law, her husband, my sister's husband, is diagnosed ADHD. We are very similar. Very similar. And he jokingly says that I am also ADHD. So I scheduled an appointment to go and get tested a while back. What am I looking for? Oh, gloves and hair dye. Anyway, they got distracted. I guess they have computer form testing and the written testing. The written testing, I was like, man, this makes so much sense. Like, this is totally my brain. I love this. This makes a whole lot of sense for me. I do the written testing. I do the computer part of the testing. And my psychologist comes in and she says that I passed with flying colors, which means I am totally ADD and ADHD. I don't really know the difference right now. But it doesn't really change anything. It's exactly what I know anyways about myself. It just maybe establishes like some form of community to talk to other people about this. A bigger reason why I finally went and got tested is because, is because I realized in this season of life how my brain was functioning before kids and how it's trying to transfer over and function into this new season of life with my special needs children. It's not working. It's not cooperating. I have recently just been on an extreme amount of, I'm very careful with the words that I use, but struggling with anxiety and I needed help. So I finally started seeing a therapist. I'm learning to unlearn some things of medicine, how it can be a helpful tool if it's not abused, how I used to use it. for sure, like, come to Christ first, pray about if he would have you, who he would have you talk to, and the therapist that he would maybe, like, guide you to. But for me, they would just start it off with a joke, and then the Holy Spirit would, like, no, I actually want to use this. I was like, okay. It's hard to do all of this. It's hard that my brain isn't wanting to work how it used to work, and I don't understand that, but I have realized that chemical imbalance is really a thing. Definitely genetics in my family. Generational curses are also a thing. And alcoholism is broken off by the power of the blood of Jesus because of how the Holy Spirit encountered me the night that I tried to take my life. And he spoke and said, no, this generational curse is here. So that's different. Chemical imbalance is a whole different discussion. But this is actually hard. Why did I choose to record like this? Talking about how hard it is to do things and the tasks and having just so much on the plate. It's just, I can't even find the time to want to take a shower. I don't want to take a shower. That's gross. But I'm trying. I really am. Like, I'm just always needed. Even in the showers, it's not like I couldn't even have 10 minutes to myself, which takes longer to take a shower, obviously, but I have to make it work because my children just constantly need me. My husband needs me. Sometimes I just can't breathe, and that's hard. I'm learning that it's okay to not be okay, but still learning to lay everything down at the Lord's feet. I know he's bringing us through this. I've grown a lot in this season. Don't know how to handle everything. It's such a mental effort to do stuff. I had my moment. I'm okay now. I just gotta keep going. I have a lot that I'm supposed to be doing today. I currently do hair 3 times a week. Mondays are my Sabbath day where I'm supposed to be resting, but it's converted into my office days right now. Lord, forgive me. I'm a full-time caregiver at the same time. Fridays, I'm trying to set aside time as, like, content creating and editing and podcasting and transitioning into that. Weird. I've never recorded like this before. Oh man, I stopped to blow dry my hair. I really don't want to. Start letting it air dry, actually. I need to go change those diapers still, too. I need to drink water. Let's go drink water. Of course, my son has all the bathrooms. Yeah, the baby peed. Huh?
Dada, no!
So funny. Babe, do I have a port?
Baby.
Yeah, definitely. I am going to be so vulnerable right now. I would bring this in public.